加纳共和国，简称加纳，位于非洲西部几内亚湾北岸，西临科特迪瓦，北接布基纳法索，东皮多哥，南濒大西洋。在西非国家中，加纳经济较为发达，被誉为非洲国家经济结构调整的样板，以农业为主，黄金、可可和木材三大传统出口产品是其经济支柱。加纳因盛产黄金，独立前称黄金海岸，同时是世界上最大的可可生产国和出口国之一。据说全世界每6块巧克力中就有1块原料来自加纳，被称为可可之乡。本期节目让我们走进一带一路上的黄金海岸加纳，通过加纳驻华大使爱德华·博阿腾的讲述，去了解中加两国之间源远流长的邦交历史，领略一带一路倡议下两国愈加深厚的友谊。非洲是海上丝绸之路的历史和自然延伸。近年来，非洲国家积极响应中国“一带一路”倡议。加纳作为西非第二大经济体，拥有地理优势、资源优势和战略优势。加纳政府提出的“一县一厂、一村一坝”等社会经济发展规划，打造加纳东部走廊和西部走廊，振兴加纳铁路、公路，以兴建基础设施为重点，实现加纳国家内部以及加纳与西共体国家的互联互通，与一带一路重大倡议的精神高度契合，为加强中加合作提供了广阔空间。中加在共建一带一路框架下，加快推进全方位合作，实现发展战略对接，一个个工程和项目在加纳落地，技术培训和文化交流次第展开，一带一路倡议为加纳经济增长和社会发展增添了新的亮点和能量，也书写着中加人民携手合作共同逐梦的精彩故事。
Ghana and China have had very long diplomatic relations. In fact, we're the second country in sub-Saharan Africa to establish diplomatic relations with China in 1960. Also the third country to open its embassy. So we've been in China for a very long time. We've had a very sincere and trusted relationship over the years. And we believe that going forward in the spirit of the new era as proposed by President Xi, this relationship is going to be deepened. Where do I think we can cooperate further is in the areas of education, because I strongly believe that the people-to-people exchange proposed by President Xi during the FOCAC summit, which is one of the 8 key areas of development, are very, very important. Today in China, Ghana has the highest number of African students. We have about 6,700 African students in all disciplines, undergrads, masters, and PhD students across all disciplines. The Confucius Institute also has 2 centers in Ghana, and we're hoping to open more. We also hope to invite more Chinese students to come to Ghana to understand our culture, to learn, and also, most importantly, use Ghana as a base to understand the rest of Africa. The other area that I believe we can also cooperate is in the area of technology transfer. I think China has done a very, very wonderful job over the last 40 years in terms of innovation. And we believe that we can learn a lot from China in terms of how do we innovate in terms of our cultural context to help develop the needed industries, the needed services that will lift our people out of poverty. The last area that we need cooperation on is in the area of infrastructure development and agriculture. If we can work with China to develop our roads, develop our water networks, develop the needed infrastructure that would help to improve our agricultural sector, it will help create a lot of jobs, and in so doing, help lift our people out of poverty. I think China has lifted almost 600 to 700 million people out of poverty over the last decade, and that is something that we would like to emulate. Well, as I said, today China is Ghana's largest trading partner. And also in terms of developmental projects, China is our largest trading partner. We are looking at areas of development in the medical field. We are looking at areas of development in the health, medical and health sector, also in the educational sector. We're hoping to work with China to build more technical and training institutions for our people. We're also looking at working with China in the agricultural sector. These are the areas that we are collaborating presently.
加纳自1960年与中国建交，中加缔造和培育了传统友好关系，尤其在一带一路倡议和中非合作论坛北京峰会的框架下，两国在政治、经贸、人文等领域合作成果丰硕。中国已成为加纳最大的贸易伙伴国和最大的外资来源地。2016年，两国贸易额达 59.76 亿美元。目前，中国正在加快推进一带一路建设，为包括加纳等非洲国家在内的世界各国带来更广阔的合作机遇。加方将与中国加强在矿产、能源、农业等领域的合作，成为一带一路建设的新亮点、新名片。中加两国不断增进政治互信，深化互利合作，密切人文交流，推动中加友好合作取得新成果，更好地造福两国人民，赋予中加关系新的活力和内涵。中加始终是互相信赖的好朋友和共同发展的好伙伴。
In this era of multilateralism, I think it's important for countries to collaborate. I think China has undoubtedly shown that it's a leader in the multilateral approach to development. And I think that's where the Belt and Road comes in. I think Ghana is a leader in terms of African political and economic affairs. And China can count on us as a global partner to develop the BRI. I think BRI presents opportunities for all countries to develop hand in hand so that no country is left behind. I think it's important that as we send people to the moon, as we send spacecraft to Mars, as we innovate, the smallest and the weakest people are always carried along. That is my understanding of Belt and Road, that President Xi is looking at a situation where the strong can carry the weak. And we believe that a lot of us in Africa need some help. And that's the sort of help that President Xi is providing. Now, for those of us who are strong in Africa, it's also our duty to carry the weak in our region. So we are going to work closely with the leadership of China, the leadership of Africa, the leadership of AU, the leadership of other countries that believe in this to make sure that we all build a better world for tomorrow. China has always been a good friend of Africa. China has a unique position of being one of the biggest countries in the world that has never colonized any country in Africa. We can't say that of other strong countries. Also, they've always never interfered in our domestic affairs. In other areas, aid or help is tied to, you do this before I do this for you. We've never had that situation with China. And China helped a lot in the liberation struggle of a lot of African countries. So we in Africa do appreciate, especially Ghana, do appreciate the relationship we have with China. For a long time, the relationship was at a political level. So as I said, now we're bringing it down to the people-to-people level. This year, for instance, we have brought in 25 children aged between 10 and 15 years who spent a few weeks in China interacting with Chinese children, interacting with going around just to learn what China is. Next year, we're going to send a similar number of Chinese children to Ghana. These were things that were not happening before, but we believe that if people start interacting at a very early age, they form their own opinions of what is and what should not be, not from what they are told by their teachers or by books. That's what we are hoping to do.
2012年，中共十八大明确提出倡导人类命运共同体意识。至此以后，命运共同体是中国政府反复强调的关于人类社会的新理念。面对世界经济的复杂形势和全球性问题，一种以应对人类共同挑战为目的的全球价值观已开始形成，并逐步获得国际共识。加纳国家领导人对习近平总书记提出的一带一路、人类命运共同体等理念给予了高度评价。加纳积极参与共建一带一路和中非命运共同体，深化双边及中非互利合作，为双边和中非关系发展注入新的强劲动力，共同推进构建更加紧密的中非命运共同体。
So in terms of making the world a fairer place, we've been working with China on that. I think today most of the world is about economics. If you look at what is happening in terms ofthe supposed trade wars. How do we work with China to ensure that everybody has a bit of the pie? I think that is what we are looking at. That's why we believe that through our voice, we can also help China also to be a fairer player. Because at the end of the day, I mean, China is also my father Christmas. So we also have to ensure that the opportunities thatwe are getting from China is also fair and not one-sided. So we hope to engage the leadership on all aspects. But I think so far the relationship has been one of mutual respect, one of win-win, and we hope to develop it further. I think where BRI can assist us is to link us through the railway network. Because I think that if we can haveThe railway is going through all these countries. It makes the movement of goods and services faster. And that's what one of the things that we are looking for. I think Ghana has always been the political hub of West Africa, the political hub of most of Africa. If you look at a lot of the freedom fighters in the 50s and 60s, most of them lived in Ghana. Or they started their fight for independence from Ghana. So we've always had that leadership role.And we'll continue to play it. Then what we need to look at now is more of the economics. How can Ghana become the economic hub from which we can help the other African countries? We're not the biggest of the countries in West Africa. We have our big brothers in Nigeria, but we have our role to play. And I believe that we can be the center of economic, political, and social activityfor China to move into the rest of the African region. We have a very stable government, we have a very, very educated workforce, and we have a fairly developed infrastructural base, and most importantly, the people. I think in most countries, what will make you live there is the country. I mean, there are a lot of people who want to live in China today and like being in China because when you are here, it's very...secure. You know, unlike most countries where you go to bed, you have to lock your doors. You know, in China you can walk around in most Chinese cities and not, you don't have the fear of being mobbed. You know, in Ghana it's like that. So we are a very welcoming society and I believe that these are some of the attributes that make us the ideal place for which the BRI should be anchored.I think we would welcome all your viewers to Ghana, especially if it's your first time you want to go to Africa. Ghana is one of the most ideal places to visit. It's really a tourist haven and easy to get to, and we're very, very friendly people.
在共建“一带一路”和中非合作论坛框架指引下。中加各领域合作蓬勃发展，中国在加纳实施的援助、融资、投资、工程承包项目不胜枚举，其中天然气基础设施、电信骨干网、远程教育项目、安索固电厂和非洲世界航空以及多条公路项目，为加纳经济社会发展做出重要贡献，而且极大促进互联互通。 当前，中方正与加方新政府密切沟通，推动新一批基建和民生项目早日落地，让中加合作的成果尽快惠及当地人民。中国将在对加合作中坚持以和平合作、开放包容、互学互鉴、互利共赢为核心的思路精神，坚持真实亲诚的对非工作方针和正确义利观，坚持共商共建共享原则，推动一带一路建设国际合作，与加纳携手应对世界经济面临的挑战，共同打造全球利益共同体和人类命运共同体。